Ships are some of the oldest forms of transport in history. Before we had planes, they were one way for people to move goods for vast distances across the world. However, while shipping today is often considered safe, ships of the past sunk quite often. Wooden ships often sank when they hit bad weather, but ships today sink far less in such conditions thanks to newer technology. While the weather still plays a part in many of the sinkings of large ships, they are able to survive much better in ocean swells than they used to. So how do modern ships stay afloat through massive storms? Storms at sea can be some of the most intense experiences out there. From towering walls of water to strong winds, it's truly incredible what ships have to endure to stay afloat. In fact, one way that modern ships avoid sinking in massive storms involves a technology that ships of old never had access to: weather reports. One way that ships generally avoid sinking in storms is by simply avoiding the storms in the first place. By using predictive and real-time weather reports, captains can plot their courses and even determine departure and arrival dates with great accuracy. In voyages of the past, ships just had to set out and hope they didn't hit bad weather. Modern ships get weather reports and updates through satellite and single sideband radio aboard. For example, U.S. ships must carry a Navtex machine or navigational telex machine that picks up radio signals and converts them into text. It's in this way that ships can get up-to-date weather reports without worrying about a cell connection. Aside from avoiding storms, modern ships have other factors that help keep them afloat when the waters get choppy. Ballasts, which were also in use in ancient times, are weights that help stabilize ships in rough seas by making the ship harder to toss around. However, while ballasts do help, the safest ship in a big storm is a fully loaded ship due to the fact that more cargo weight makes the ship harder to push around. Because modern ships can carry more cargo and are larger than ever, they actually become harder to sink. But even in the case of a fully loaded ship, the cargo shifting overboard can unbalance the boat. When ships are empty, even with ballasts, they can be more vulnerable to large swells. When ships do encounter harsh weather and the ballasts aren't enough, they have to rely on sturdy engineering. Modern ships are constructed with strong, heavy steel. This makes the hulls more resistant to damage. However, repeated impacts from large waves can and do cause harm. While the steel exterior of ships can generally sustain most things that a storm throws at it, repeated blows in the same area of a ship from crashing waves can weaken the steel through something called fatigue stress. Fatigue results in minute changes in the molecular structure of the steel, making it less strong over time. Given enough cycles of stress and strain on the boat, ships can and do break apart due to fatigue failures. Eventually, this could cause the hull to fail, letting water inside the ship. To prevent this, modern ships have incredibly thick steel hulls and strong internal support structures to increase the endurance limit of the ship. But how do ships survive storms when they're stuck in port? Well, they have two options. Hurricane hulls are ports with good holding and protection from winds. But in some ports, large ships may be asked to leave before storms because the ships can quickly destroy even the sturdiest of ports while being pushed around in the waves. In either case, ships need to be well anchored with slack in the chain to prevent them from being snapped by the motion of the waves. The crew can also put the ship in reverse to put more pressure on the anchor. If caught far from a port, the best bet is actually to outrun the storm. Most modern cargo ships can reach at least 14 knots, enough to outrun most hurricanes, especially with a good deal of advanced warning. If all else fails, then ship captains can try to steer into the calmest part of the storm. In a hurricane, the low side or clean side of the storm is the side counterclockwise from its leading edge. Piloting a ship to this side of the storm is the best bet for survival. The ship's survival in this case often depends on two things: sea room and steering way. Sea room means that the ship is a safe distance from anything it might crash into, like a coastline. Steering way means the ship is moving forward with enough power to steer against the wind and waves. It is vital that the ship keeps its bow pointing into the waves, since being struck side on by a large wave can roll or capsize a vessel of any size. When piloting the ships through these massive waves, the crew has to work hard to keep the ship moving forward to hit the waves at a right angle. Ships are designed to roll side to side and up and down and still survive thanks to their strong hull. All that movement certainly doesn't make the crew feel their best, but at least the ships can hold up and keep everyone alive.